mother continues to take Halloween to a whole new level.
We are talking, yeah, wait, a whole new level. Stephanie Pokorny from Menor is back with the cute little guys. Two of them are her sons, one her nephew. And these are some of the crocheted costumes that she has made for her children over the years. I don't know how you did it. I knit, so I have an unbelievable appreciation for this. But you do this by crochet, right?
I do, yeah. Yes. These, these are crochet, yep. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
It's just amazing. How long does it take you to make each costume?
Each one takes me about 50 hours to do. I don't keep exact track, but I give myself about 2 weeks to do it. So I estimate somewhere around 50 hours, but maybe a little more.
Incredible. And the detail is incredible.
Thank you.
Because look at the dinosaur. You got a little dinosaur stuff coming from
slime.
The side.
Yeah, we have some drool.
It's the alien.
Yeah. So this is my favorite right here.
Thank you.
We have to show some of these over here too. Now I have to ask you, because I remember when my kids were little, they would change their, like, I'm going to be so and so, and then a month later they change. What happens? Are your kids just not allowed to change their minds?
Well, no, actually, I think in developing this tradition, they've become very resolute in their decisions.
Okay, they
so
know.
They're part of it. So
there's
they know.
Smurf.
Yeah, they know
a
by
smurf?
September 1st that they have to be decided. Mm-hmm. And since they're involved in the making of it, they get excited and don't change.
That's awesome. Yeah. Okay. Well, and then also, we probably have some pictures too that we can show.
Yeah.
But the clown. Look at this.
That's a nice clown.
He got a hair fix this morning.
Fixed him up.
And I let them play in them throughout the year. So
this is incredible. Do you do any other type of crocheting?
That's actually Pennywise.
It's not just a clown.
I crochet clothing.
Everything.
Yep, pretty much anything.
And when you look at these costumes, they are so detailed. They're incredible.
They
ooh,
are.
Okay.
Don't scare Wayne.
I scare very easily.
There you go.
Very nice, though.
Do you guys like these costumes? Do you feel extra special in them?
Yeah.
I know you do. Do you wear them on Halloween to go trick-or-treating?
Yes.
I understand.
And it keeps them nice and warm.
I know.
Oh, for sure. Definitely.
So Ripley's, believe it or not, I understand, has done something with you since we've seen you last year.
Yeah, we actually, for our costumes last year, we made it into the book. And
that's incredible.
And we may end up in one of their museums. Hey, Jake and Jack,
can I just ask you one question? How did you even get started doing this? I mean, you've taken it to a whole new level, but how did you get started?
When Jack was a baby, I made my first one, which was this caterpillar right over here.
Oh, that's the first one.
Yep, from Alice in Wonderland. Mm-hmm. And he liked it. It kept them warm, and I really liked to do it. And so I know that my mom always made my costumes, and I loved it when they did that. And so, therefore, I wanted to create that tradition with them.
And you're not using a pattern or anything. This is just, you're going off a picture or what?
1 second.
They're box eight by the time I was.
Yeah. They are totally free-handed. I don't do any patterns for them. I create patterns throughout the rest of the year. But for Halloween, it's like our fun time, our outlet. We just go for it. No keeping track or anything. Just fun. Just
what if people wanted to buy some of this stuff?
Well, for the completed costumes, I don't sell them, but I do create patterns for other items, such as costume components, like hats and things of that nature.
Okay. Yeah.
I just have to ask you one question. Where do you start? Because starting for me on projects that I would knit was always the hardest place. Where do you start on one of these?
Well, first things first, they tell me Jacob, come back, sweetheart. We have a very active alien here.
I love that alien.
So where I start is they tell me what they want to be, and then I start researching pictures of the character.
Wow.
And I try to find angles, you know, every single angle, so I can best see what he looks like from all sides.
That's incredible.
So I can best recreate it in the medium of yarn when it comes time for that.
I like the dreads.
I do too. So cute. And we have to say that there is no child in here, but it did fool both me and Wayne.
Yes.
This is just a mannequin.
Bigger than mine.
Oh, you said his head is bigger than yours?
Yeah.
Oh.
Thank you for showing us again this
thank
year.
Thank you so much.
You are amazing.
Thank you.
Boys, thank you for being
thank
with
you.
Us.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Hey,
appreciate you guys.
All right.